In this segment, let's take an example of finding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors numerically. So let's suppose the problem statement is saying use power method to find largest eigenvalue, by magnitude and corresponding vector of this matrix. So somebody is giving you the A matrix and is asking you to find that. So you have 1.5, 0, 1, minus 0.5, 0.5, minus 0.5, minus 0.5, 0, 0. So let's see how that works here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take an initial guess. So this is the problem statement. So let your initial guess, let's suppose, be equal to 1, 1, 1. And what we have to do is we have to assume one of them, of course, when we're making the initial guess of a non-zero starting eigenvector, one of the components has to be 1. Although we chose 1, 1, 1 as all the components, let's suppose it is the first component which I'm going to always keep 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do A times X naught, my initial guess, and this so it will be 1.5, 0, 1, minus 0.5, 0.5, minus 0.5, minus 0.5, 0, 0, and I multiply by 1, 1, 1. What am I going to get? I'm going to get 2.5, minus 0.5, and minus 0.5. But what I want to do is I want to make keep the first component of this eigenvector to be always 1. So I'm going to say I'll have to divide by 2.5. So it'll be 2.5, and I'll get 1, and I'll get minus 0.2 and minus 0.2. So that's my first initial guess of the first guess which I get for the eigenvalue. And this is the first guess I get for the eigenvector, of course. But I don't have anything to compare it with so far as the eigenvalue is concerned, so I'm going to go for one more iteration, let's suppose. So now my x of 1 is equal to whatever I get there, 1 minus 0.2 and minus 0.2. I will do A times x of 1, and I will multiply the A vector, which is this, and I'm going to multiply by the x vector, which is, which I found 1 minus 0.2 minus 0.2. And when I do the matrix multiplication, this is what it turns out to be. It turns out to be 1.3, minus 0.5, and minus 0.5. And since I have said that the first component of this eigenvector is always going to be 1, this becomes 1.3 times 1 minus 0.3846 minus 0.3846. So this is my second estimate of the eigenvalue. Now what I can do is I can compare this number and this number right here to see that how close I'm coming to the eigenvalue. So we had the first estimate as 2.5 as our first estimate, and then 1.3 as our next estimate. So what is the relative approximator here? It will be the current approximation is 1.3 minus the previous approximation 2.5 divided by 1.3. I'm going to multiply it by 100, and that number turns out to be 92.307%. So that seems to be a large error. So what you have to do is you have to keep on doing this process till you find out that it is less than your pre-specified tolerance. So I have a few numbers here. So let's look at what do we get as we keep on going through the process here. So let's suppose I have a table here which I'm going to make for what step I am at, what is the value of lambda I'm calculating, what is the corresponding value of the eigenvector I'm calculating, and what is my absolute relative approximate error in percentage in terms of the eigenvalues concerned. So we already saw that, hey, when I do my first iteration, my eigenvalue turns out to be 2.5, and the corresponding eigenvector turns out to be 1, minus 0.2, and minus 0.2. And I cannot calculate my relative approximate error there, so that's my first one. If I look at my second one, we just calculated as 1.3, and the corresponding eigenvector turned out to be 1 minus 0.3846 minus 0.3846, and the relative approximate turned out to be 92.307%. So I can continue doing this process, and I'm going to find out that, let's suppose if I do some more iterations, let's suppose if I'm at the fifth iteration. So I'm skipping showing you the values for 3 and 4, but at the end of the fifth iteration, I get 1.02459 as my eigenvalue. The eigenvector corresponding to that I get is 1 minus 0.488 and minus 0.4880 I get here. And the relative approximate which I get is 1.2441%. So if somebody had asked me that, hey, I want you to calculate your eigenvalue within, let's suppose, 2% error, I would have stopped here saying that, hey, I get 1.2441% as my relative approximate error, and this is my estimate of the eigenvalue, and this is my estimate of the eigenvector. Now, if you would have kept on going through this process, you will find out that the exact value turns out to be that lambda eigenvalue, the largest eigenvalue is 1, and the eigenvector which will have the first value as 1 would have been 1 minus 0.5 minus 0.5. So if you keep on going through this process, you'll get closer and closer to the exact value of 1 and the eigenvector of 1 minus 0.5 and minus 0.5. And that's how the power method works. So keep in mind that the power method only finds the largest eigenvalue in magnitude, and the way to continue the iterations is to choose one of the components to be unity and keep on and insist that it is unity for all the steps. That's how we're going to get the convergence to that particular eigenvalue, and whatever is the eigenvector, the vector corresponding to the satisfaction of Ax equal to lambda x will be your eigenvector. And that's the end of this segment.